Hello everyone, welcome to Arthrill Studio, and here it's Anuja. And today we are going to do some amazing borders to beautify your Madhubani painting. As we all know that in Madhubani painting, it looks very incomplete without beautiful borders. So let's get started. I have taken an A4 size paper and I divided it in few borders. I used scale to make lines, thicker borders and thin borders. And I am using the drawing nib and a holder to draw my borders. We are going to do really beautiful borders using Camel waterproof drawing ink. It is important for us to take waterproof ink because it will not bleed when we will start to color it. We will repeat our pencil lines with the nib and make our borders. We will do thin lines and thicker lines, dividing it into different size of portions. It looks really beautiful when we alternate our borders with thick or thin. You can use any of these designs individually also to make borders. You can also combine them to make broad borders in your dress, on your canvas, on paper, and it will look amazingly beautiful. A beautiful border can transform your picture to another level. So you are leaving the flowers in the middle and covering the background with Kachni lines. Again repeating the border, the thin one. We have to really take care of our combinations. You can mix and match all the borders that we are doing here today. Drawing the big circle, just the shape, just as the size of a coin. We can do our borders in geometric shapes, floral patterns. We can also make elements like fish, birds, humans also, and give it a theme to our picture. Here we are making small stems and leaf to cover the design. We can also leave the design in black and white, and we can also color it depending on whatever we choose. You can go ahead and do very, very intricate design, and you can also space your design out to make space for some color portions. So moving to our third border, again we will do the lines. This is a floral border. Just making some flower petals and the leaves in the side will make the whole border very broad. We will alternate it, facing it opposite. And it will look very beautiful when colored. So first we will draw all the borders and then we will color them one by one. So this is a floral pattern, mix of broad band and a thin band, both with flowers. We can also make geometric shapes. Here I'm dividing my section into rectangles and then making geometric pattern. Our fourth border again is the... If you are liking my video, do subscribe my channel, show your love and appreciation by subscribing to the channel and giving it a like. Now here we are doing few elements like elephant. Elephant is a, such motifs are a part of our Godhna style of Madhubani painting. The small motifs of elephants look very beautiful, followed by the geometric pattern on the top. We can use just single line border also, or we can make couple of borders together. The next is a floral one. We are adding the flower and the leaf. Filling the negative spaces with black. Few lines. And this will be a beautiful border combination. Our next border will be of a shank. This is a conch shank. If we are making any painting of gods and goddesses or any religious text we are doing context, then we can just do this shank. So you have to choose your border wisely. It should complement the theme of your picture. There are a few general borders, very thin ones, geometric patterns, small flowers, they go with everything. But if in case you are doing some fish motif, some peacock motif, conch, humans, then we need to see the theme also. These are few borders. We will make another set of borders which will have beautiful human design and fish design. So again, doing the outlines, and now it is our bird design here. All the elements are considered very auspicious, and such elements give lot of brightness to the picture. So when we do the border, it can transform our picture to another level. It can bring lot of beauty to the picture. There are a lot of videos on my channel as to how to make birds, how to make different kinds of birds, how to make different types of flowers, leaves, and full tutorials so that you do not fall short on the elements. So you can watch those videos as well. Do not forget to subscribe the channel. Now our next one is with the a wavy pattern, and now this is a fish. This border goes in continuation and it looks very, very nice. Just repeating the same design on both the sides of our fish. Adding the leaves to some extra space to give it more fill up look. Now our thin borders. You can also follow me on my Instagram page. Do connect with me on my Facebook page. And these are few simple borders that are aligned together. It always looks nice when you do a broad one followed by a thinner one. A big design followed by a very simple continuation design. So here I am doing a very broad border where we have ladies. So generally if we are doing any celebration, this motif continuously, when we draw it in a row, it forms the border also. This is a main part of the Godhna style of it. My next video following would be Godhna style, how to do different styles of paintings. You can add some leaves, flowers in the center to give it more full look, festive kind of look. This looks as if it's a celebration or marriage or anything. If you want to do that sort, then you can add on this kind of a border where everybody is happy and rejoicing. Coming to our next border. Making few heart shape. They look beautiful when we do the full color. We can also use alternate colors for each heart. Red, green, orange, yellow. So it doesn't follow the same that heart has to be red. We can do assorted colors or alternate colors. They look equally nice. Now here, doing the simple border in vertical form, followed by a block of flowers. We can also repeat the same as we did the heart on the top. We can repeat the same one down also, and we can do a separate border. Here I'm just doing small curves to give you the variety and option when you do the painting. This is a simple, very blank border with few flowers and the space in the middle that shows water. We will replicate the same design on top and bottom. Those are curves. And we will add a few dashes for our space in the center where the lotus is. Now let's start the coloring and see our borders look bright and beautiful. You can use different colors and combinations for your borders. Enjoy working with different kind of colors and see how our painting transforms. Always try to take contrasts in your border so that it looks very bright and colorful. Here I am using brush pens. You can also use sketch pens, acrylic paints, poster colors, whatever is available we can do. This picture I am doing with the brush pens, which are very similar, give the effect of watercolors. There are previous tutorials on simple borders and the basic shapes. If you are new to Madhubani, it's advised that you watch them and then move on to the advanced borders. Really bright and contrasting colors will uplift your picture to another level. When we take the waterproof pen, we draw with waterproof pen. Even if you use watercolors or acrylic paints, and your colors will not bleed. So You can use any water-based paint later for coloring, but first and the foremost thing, you have to be very, very particular about using waterproof pen. We get it in Microns, Uniball. There are different brands where we can use it. You can also use ink and holder. If you are not comfortable using ink and holder, then you can use any other brush and the pen. We also do paintings directly with paint and brush when we are using it on the canvas. You can change the combinations according to what suits best to your painting. I hope you all are liking my video. Do not forget to subscribe my channel. Press on the bell icon so that you get further notifications whenever I post a video. Thanks for watching.